You're here.
Kneel before me when in my presence!
Round one. Fight! Round two. Fight!
How's it going, everybody? Welcome to Fight Night, Street Fighter V at 16-bit Bar and Arcade. Round one on stream here is technically game two of winners. We've got Jobber Alex versus Last Huzzah Orion. Round one is not a Huzzah. Orion, significant power buff in season two. Must be giving Alex quite the bit of bother. Alex undeterred, however. Jobber just getting into the zone, setting up his own frame traps here. Oh! Pretty hardcore stuff! Oh, here comes the... Oh no, the Aegis juggle. Jobber not going to be crossed up on that one. Just because they gave Arena cross up doesn't mean he has to fall for it. Jobber's got one round to keep this alive. In he goes. Oh. Orion doing a fantastic job of keep away. He knows that he cannot let Alex in whatsoever, or it could be a nasty, nasty combo. Oh! Orion, one of the few characters with enough reach to punish that boot. Jobber opening him up with a throw. Oh, here it comes. Oh! Beating out the V counter. Oh, caught him! Oh, that's gonna hurt! Jobber can keep this momentum. He'll go into the next round and hopefully keep this game alive. Oh! EX chop. Not safe. Who knew? Oh! He saw that coming! Oh, just a little bit more! Oh! There. Oh, no! Oh! Oh! Here it comes. Oh, oh no! There it is! Jobber keeps it alive! Takes it to round three of game two. Alright. Alright, Jobber starting off strong. Worry almost a stun. Oh! Air to air, not quite good. Oh, there goes all that stun progression. Worry doing a good job of keeping things even. Jobber's gotta win this or that's the end. Oh no! Catches him on a recovery frame. Oh! Crush, kill, destroy. Not quite working out for Urien today. Alex is waiting for his opening. He had all that momentum earlier. Oh no! Uh-oh, that might be it. And there it is. Last Huzzah wins 2-0 over Jobber.
Two-oh
Fritter. Wei Chang and
Jacob on the setup, and I'm already staring and pulling over there.
Okay.
I told the bartender the next thing was on me, so she knows.
Oh, cool. Thanks. All right. Coming up next, we got Wei Chang and Jacob. Hello, Jacob.
What's going on?
Do you have a handle for your stream? Do you have like a fight name?
Probably
just JSHA151. All right, let me get that in there.
SHEA.
Okay.
No space.
SHEA.
151.
All right, going in there, buddy. All right, as soon as we have your opponent out here, we'll get going. And in the meantime, I'm going to cut the mic so you folks at home don't have to hear me blather on. Okay, here we go. JSHA 151 repping the Cammy. Smack the Bunny. Classic Ryu. Here we go. This ought to be good. One of the top characters from last season versus one of the top characters from this season. Let's see what happens. Alright, both running about even. Cammy's starting to take the lead. Just whiffing out those medium punches. How does that feel, Ryu? Oh, V trigger. That wasn't safe, not one little bit. Oh, Cammy tried to catch my wake up. DP's not working out for Smack the Bunny. And Cammy takes round one. All right, here we go, back into it. Cammy just getting in there, not giving Ryu much space to work with. Oh, jump back ultra. What? Oh, it was enough. It says I will toss my whole bar away as a distraction. Oh. Gets him out of the corner. Chase that Ryu down. Cross the whole stage. We're going for it. This is happening. Oh! Crouching roundhouse. Not safe. Cammy tried to get him with the... Smack did not work. And there it is. Round two, game one. Going to Shea 151. Alright, here we go, round two, or game two, I should say. Bumping her advances. Oh, it's not enough. Oh! Somehow he stayed airborne long enough to get under the crouching ramp. There it is. Oh. Ryu rebumping her advances. Round one of game two. Here we go. Keeping it stylish. Oh! Somehow he stayed airborne long enough to get under the crouching ramp. Opening him up for big damage. Styling all over his balls. Cammy he'll take the hit, bounce back in with an EX cannon drill. And there it is, 2-0, Jim Shea, 151 over Smack the Bunny Ryu. And we are on to the next game. Right, let's see here. We got Pensive Sloth.
Yep. Defensive Sloth, aka Craig, the turn the TO.
Yep. And,
TO playing. See what happens.
Who's Brian and who?
Brian, what's your handle?
I'll be Gabby Wake Up and Smell the DP.
Yeah, wake up and smell the DP.
Pretty sure you're in there.
You can't see me. My time is now.
Oh god.
My time is now. No, you missed it. A guy behind us is doing it.
Alright.
Mash out that fucking score defaults.
So we got.
Are you guys on the appropriate sides?
Yeah, P1, Pensive Sloth, P2, wake up and smell the DP.
Cool, cool.
So we'll see. Let's see what the picks are.
Oh, God.
And the picks are just as I predicted. Nash versus Ken.
Yeah.
Got some salty controller throwing.
Saltiness of the next setup.
But
hey, Chun-Li won, so woo!
Yeah, Chun! Totally fair character.
Now she is.
Yeah, actually. So, okay. So the problem about this matchup is if Nash doesn't establish his zoning area and, like, keep control down, he can do absolutely Nathan's hot dogs about keeping Ken out.
What is Nathan's hot dog?
Nothing. He can do nothing. Yo, shout-outs to Yipes. So let's see. Some boom zoning. Going in with the Tragedy Assault. Ooh, the meaty setup with the counter hit setup, but no follow-up on the crush counter. Back to the neutral game. Okay. Ken trying to play a fake zoning game and trying to get in and out, but it's not really working. Good cross up, good block. Let's see, a lot of empty air here in this match. Not a very Street Fighter 5-y match.
It's very pensive.
Very pensive, if you will.
As if a sloth were playing of some kind.
Good jump out.
Oh.
Tries to jump out again. Gotta be careful with that. If he gets hit with that again, goes for the setup. No combo continuation.
Oh.
Gets combo for his couple. Setup? Oh, no.
Okay,
let's see. No Oki setup. No pressure. No wake-up pressure. V-trigger. Raw dog V-trigger. No punish. Fireball. Step kicks. Tatsus. Fireball. All right. There you go.
Step kicks. Tatsus. All kinds of techniques you won't see at the
fight. Oh, my. I really do. Okay, so the Nash player kept his composure a little bit lower. But I do like how the Ken player used anti-air heavy Tatsu to anti-air Nash straight out. So we got, again, a very slow start. Seems like this Nash player is really trying to just keep the game slow so he can get an advantage from that kind of slow play style. Trying to ice out the Ken. Ken, no Oki setup. Meaty was bad. See, that's the thing about Nash. I don't understand why they nerfed him. They cut his legs off in Season 2. He really wasn't all that bad in Season 1.
Cut his legs off, I say.
Saiyan! Neutral jump. Very good. I do like to see, especially in this game, neutral jump setups are so strong. You can catch people real hard on those setups.
I love to see blonde men punching each other.
So do I. Gets the setup. No combo continuation. No. Drops it.
Oh!
See, that setup is perfect.
Audience, you can't see it, but there's some heavy salt in the other fighting setup.
Yes, we got some salt.
As Chun-Li takes round two.
Killer Queen salt just pouring out. Close match. The Nash player is able to pull it out, but I wouldn't say it's the cleanest display of a Nash.
Yeah. If you ask Pensive Sloth, he'll tell you that he's no good.
Yeah, well, he says that, but everybody says that, so. There's only two types of Street Fighter players, the ones that say they're ass and the ones that say they're good. So let's see if we... So, again, a very interesting... He literally does nothing on the round start. Which is fine. If it was up to me, I think maybe next round I would instantly start with the dash up, because the Ken player also does nothing on round start. It's a good way to get the pressure started, and Nash needs to keep pressure constantly. Very good EX Tatsu to get him at anti-air, DP follow, dash up throw, Oki setup, nope, gets thrown for his trouble. Oki, Mike Tatsu, three-framer, wake up into DP. So we're back to this, like, full-screen neutral game. Gets a jump in for the punish, but not a full combo. EX, does he know it's safe? Nope. But does get the crush counter, but no combo after that. And then the EX DP right there. Let's see. I want to see this Ken pull it out. And, oh, the classic. Cross up, light kick, just sweep right after that. That is some crazy shit right there. Who does that? Round start. Again, both of them. So this is like the third round where Ken starts with a fireball and Nash starts with doing nothing. At a certain point, like, you can make a hard read off that. If I'm honest, I would have supered, like, on round start to try to catch that fireball. So you got, again, full screen neutrals. Raw EXTP. I'm guessing that was a input flub. But again, very, very slow. Very slow match to commentate. V-skill throw, V-skill crouch medium punch, EX fireball into crush counter sweep. Getting some good pressure for the Ken. He's keeping him in the corner, gets him with the overhead, continues pressure, gets thrown for his trouble, misses the medium. Oh, good sweep to punish, but...
You gotta show up for the meetings.
Yeah, he had to really get a much better punish than that. Goes for EX.
Yeah!
And the Ken slam!
Oh, Ken's on the board.
And we can hear the pop-off. So especially
that's
in this,
my favorite flavor of pop.
Especially in this game, considering Ken is like we've seen three rounds where Ken starts with fireball right off the bat. I just jump heavy like on round start, like right now, hold up forward heavy. Look at this. This time he backdashed, so that was good. But this time we see Pensacloth actually doing medium scythe on startup, which is not bad. Now the game's starting to get a little more active. So we see a lot more pressure from the Ken. Ken's really trying to push it in there. But we're seeing some good counter hit setups from the Nash, but no full continuation on the combo. A lot of combo dropping. A lot of damage left on the table for no reason. I thought this Ken was going to be straight Pringles, but like he's actually like still fighting and actually doing good block. It's the first time he blocked it, he's got hit by it twice. Goes in for pressure. Back to neutral. Tries to V-skill to anti-air, but that doesn't work. Going for the jump-in medium kick? His bazooka knee gets thrown for the bazooka knee, which is weird. Full V-skill. Oh, that's punishable. No punish.
Oh, his feet are on fire!
This Ken really trying to make stuff happen. This time he didn't block it. EXDP! So right there, what happened, he got, not yet, he got hit by the EX fireball first and then got hit by the crouching heavy punch, by the heavy punch too late, and it gave him a gap to EXDP out. Good composure by the Ken to note an EXDP there, or at least try it. Tries the EX Tatsu to catch him out of the air, but he was way too close, he didn't actually get the start up. See some trading buttons. He could have definitely DP'd that. I mean, he would have traded, but he would have gotten a lot more damage than he would have taken. Good block on the cross up. Goes for the overhead into the low. Now we're starting to see the Ken starting to blow a lot of meter, which should make the Nash player be a lot more aggressive because, you know, DPs aren't invulnerable anymore. Only EXs are. So if I was that Nash, I wouldn't backdash at all. I'd be completely inside while he didn't have meter. But now it's too late. Ken should have meter by the next time they meet. Yep, there he goes. Oh. So let's see what the read will be.
Oh,
and he goes for the up, but he doesn't get the full combo.
Oh!
Let's see. Let's go. Let's go. The overhead. Okay. So last round.
Last round of the last game.
Yo, ooh. That kid is coming out of nowhere, coming out of scrubland, trying to just make himself not free.
Yep. He's caught on now. He's got the downloads.
To be completely honest, because the Nash is not punishing the fireball so well, I would continue doing
that. Very good setup. That could have been so big.
That would have been a big combo, but he didn't complete it.
That was like incorrect. That could have gone right into Tatsu.
Yeah, that could have gone into medium Tatsu EXDP, I think, and that would have done a ton of damage. Oh! Speaking of EXDP, very good setup. Goes in for the dash throw. And then you see back again to this like back dash straight up. See?
Oh! It's no! There's no full combo. Crush counter.
Gets free activation for V trigger for the Ken. Heavy Tatsu all the way in. Tries the EXDP, he read it this time.
Oh no!
Oh, but not he did not V trigger cancel.
Oh! Smacked out of the air!
The
like
overhead! Oh, and he throws him back! Let's see. This is it. This is gonna be sick. Let's see what happens. They're playing the fireball game. He knows! He knows not to throw fireballs after the EXs. Oh! He tries to sneak in the V skill! Heavy Tatsu over! Oh! Unfortunate! Great match! Ryan! Yo, great job! That was
good,
sick!
Solid
that
stuff.
Was sick! That was sick!
Oh my gosh, can I fit some fail?
You need to start clinking or strumming your continuation buttons post crush counter. So, the Nash came up and told me that he was missing all of his crush counter combo setups. And I think what it is he's mistiming them by not... So, Third Strike players know this tactic really well, or this technique, where you strum buttons, hard continuation buttons constantly, right? So you can get a better chance of getting the combo to go off.
Get Craig for me.
Okay, sure, hold on. Craig!
They're requesting a link to the bracket in the chat.
Yeah, we're good. Okay, so we should have the link to the bracket coming up here pretty soon. But so far, pretty good. That match was pretty hype. I do like the overhead axe kick as an anti-air. That is a genius idea.
That was amazing.
That was perfect.
All right, here it is. Matt, 16-bit Fight Night 2.
Okay, thanks.
So we got the link coming down right now. On the other setup, we got Game Over for You, Kid, with
Taco Supreme.
Oh, it's Taco Supreme now. Sorry. Taco Supreme. I couldn't make it a food thing.
Cthulhu.
Cthulhu tacos.
No, Taco-thulu.
Taco-thulu. Taco-thulu.
Thunier's
taco. Thunier's taco. Get the fuck out. Just play your match. Play your match. God damn.
Take a lap.
Holy shit. So Thu told me that he has new tech.
Oh.
Some upgraded.
Well, we got Devil Magneto in the chat.
Oh, hey, what's going on, man?
Clot or not. What's up, guys?
Okay, actually. We'll be right
back.
We gotta get some.
Our TO is having us congregate for a minor issue. We'll be right back. We'll cut the mic in the meantime. Okay, guys, welcome back. I'm gonna change this around. Hey, how's it going? Matchstick here, your streamer extraordinaire. Just letting you know, it was all happy news. Don't worry, tournament's gonna get back underway here in just a minute. Sadly, we cannot show you what Taco Supreme is doing to his opponent on the next setup. But actually, you know what? Maybe we can. Let's get Super Jank up in here. There's Taco Supreme. Yeah, he loves the camera and the camera him. Let's see if we can catch what's happening up there. We got a Karin. And, Taco Supreme has selected Fong. What kind of nutsness is this? Oh, okay, they're starting to set up for the next game over here, but until we have two contenders, we will keep halfway watching the next fight. It's looking pretty good. All right. Enough of that nonsense. Who are you fighting?
Ryan.
Okay. Ryan Vile. All right, so we got Ryan Vile, and I know it. Hang on.
All right. And we're back. And I'm back.
That's good, because everyone cared about you.
Everyone cares about me. Nobody cares about me.
All right, Brian Violet. Dude, I'm sorry. I keep forgetting your play name.
I'm not going to tell you. Eli will tell you.
I will find it.
Which
it's
one
in
is
here?
It? Okay, it's Livewire now.
It was Livewire last time.
Well, you used to always go by, like...
Ocelot.
Yeah, Ocelot U. So we got...
All right.
We got Ryanville versus Livewire. So this should be a Laura versus Birdie match. One of the two birdies we have here today.
It's true. We got two birdies and an Alex. And
two
a,
birdies and
a
Alex.
A
Chun.
We got a Fong, apparently.
That's Thu. Thu doesn't count.
If Henry was here, we'd have a Zangief.
Yeah.
Yo Henry.
What?
Yo Henry.
No, he's not here.
No, he's not here.
I thought you said Yo Henry.
Much
no
much
Henry.
Like Columbus itself, we have a wide diversity of characters that we all play.
Yeah, it's true. It's true. I think we have one local Vega.
Yes.
That's Freddy.
You're right.
I'm the only other person who has a pocket Vega here, and I don't even play this game.
All right, we're going to swap over to... Oh, yeah, it's Christmas time, motherfuckers!
Woo! That Christmas costume. Fuck yeah. So, okay.
So, wait, I might have these backwards here.
No, you got them right.
Okay.
Yeah. So, in this match, of course, this is season 2. Laura is brain dead and she wins everything for free.
But Birdie is no slouch either.
No. If Birdie can get the right buttons, get the right setups, bananas and cans.
Bananas and cans.
He can maybe make it set up.
That's a t-shirt right there.
Yeah, bananas and cans is
bananas
totally a
cans.
T-shirt. Okay, so we got...
Personally, I'm hoping for a Winter Wonderland.
No. Very good
bull. There's already one in my pants.
God damn it. So we got good normals, good buttons. So the birdie's getting a life lead, mainly due to the fact he has so much health. So let's see, any Oki setup? Goes for the meaty, goes into the jump out, gets no jump out. I think that was a button flub.
Oh,
tries to EX chain
it,
but can't through. He's got a real strong hit of armor.
Good matchup there.
Understands
though,
and he walks out. A very good walkout. Good read.
Yep.
Tries to anti-air it, but misses.
Oh, no.
And
oh, what happened? Oh, no.
Okay, just keep it going.
Just keep it going.
Okay, gets hit by from the fireball anti-air. That anti-air fireball could have totally been canceled into like the DP.
Yep. Alright. Round one, Laura, Ryan Vile.
Steve Harvey.
Steve
yes,
Harvey.
It is definitely Steve Harvey versus Laura.
So good.
Laura's way too good in this game right now.
Birdie's out here announcing himself the winner. Little does he know.
So luckily Laura missed the meaty timing on the throw setup. Let's see if she can get it again. Set up, cross up. All blocked. And then gets regular thrown. Pressure. Okay, good buttons from the birdie. He's trying, but gets crush counter first trouble. Into Oki setup. EX. Yep, I knew that was coming. Mainly because he told me that that's what he likes to do.
Oh!
Fully charged EX fireball on the taunt.
She said, Merry fucking Christmas, you heathen.
Holy shit. The dirt. Is this third strike? Are we playing third strike right now? It's just taunts everywhere?
Yep.
Yo, let's go. If we played that, I'd actually be in the tournament.
Alright, let's see what happens in game two.
So Birdie was doing well, but I noticed a lack of food, banana, and candy. And
I love a participant who actually types out the O and yeah.
Definitely an O moment right there. That was dirty. Yo, he made that birdie look straight Pringles. And the good chain through the fireball. Goes for the setup.
That is a very bad detraction from her
tick
fireball.
Tick command grab setup.
Crazy.
He tries to armor through, but her armor's faster and better. Because that carriage is better. V-trigger activate. Dash up.
Man, Santa's elves are a lot sexier than I
expected. The teabag in the corner. Disqualify these men. Good thing this isn't KI. They'd be out. Right now. They'd be out of the tournament. Oh,
says,
you know what's really funny? That's
while
not
my
a
fireball gets here, I guess I'll go do some stuff.
That's not an actual setup, but it is a very good visual bait because people's brains shut the fuck off when they
it's
see that.
True. Oh, weird hitbox.
Very good hitbox. It's actually a really good air-to-air button.
I'll bet. Oh.
Now he can do, he's got a good anti-air. Oh, gets hit by the overhead.
Nope.
Tries to sneeze.
Tries to be.
Drash up throw. Just needs one more. EX Dolphin Dive. Not a bad setup. Made a really good read. The problem is now, if he tries to go for the same setup, the lower player is going to jump out for sure 100%. So he needs to be aware that he has to make it weird.
Yep.
And the thing about the can and the banana...
That's hard for Laura.
So Bernie's normals make people respect him. Yeah, that's true. Okay. But against Laura, it's kind of hard. But the can and the banana forces respect from longer distances, which helps. So that's what he needs.
Yep. No, but Bernie's got crazy setups with those cans and bananas.
Oh, yeah, definitely. Very good. Tries to EX, but no B trigger to make himself safe.
Not safe.
Full setup. Oh.
These combos. I'm just.
Oh, it gets EX Dolphin Dive. It just hit on the very tippity tip of the hitbox.
Dolphin Dive, huh? Do you suppose he did that on porpoise?
Yes, he definitely did that on porpoise. And then here we go. The Laura special. He should. Yep.
Is that going to be enough?
That's going to be it.
Woo! All right.
So the Laura special is those two things. You get any throw, you can do EX command throw after that, right? If you get the light elbow, you can do regular throw after you get, like if you hit it as a combo, you can throw. Nobody texts that throw. And then neutral jump into like command grab, which is the dumbest thing. Everyone should know that's coming. Everyone gets hit by it.
What can you do, really?
Well, mainly it's because everyone sees all the crazy Laura combos. They're like, you must be doing a combo now.
Exactly.
And that's definitely not safe.
Just basic setup.
Yeah, that's just the dumbest brain dead thing.
Just screwing with your mind. Oh!
And then he gets this time he gets a good EX dash. Goes for the can. Okay. Wrong distance for the can.
Yep,
that was definitely a banana distance.
Yeah, that was bananas.
I think if they're like a backdash away from your normals, you should definitely do that. But there we go.
Oh, set up. What's gonna happen?
This time he jumped out. He knew he was gonna jump out. Hits him with the jump air.
Ryan brings it back from the.
Hits him with the
destruction.
Neutral jump light kick to shut down. Very good job, sir.
Thank you.
Hey there, Mr. Heathen. Merry fucking Christmas.
Ryan, on a scale of 1 to 10, I give myself a 3.5. We'll get there.
What's the twist?
It's Co-opted Live. COOPTEDLIVE. All over.
Word. Yep. Drinks out for Armando and his sick ass urine.
Oh yeah.
The problem is with good Urians is they try to play the how can I say this? The respect game, the real game, right? How you're supposed to play. When in reality, all they have to do is be a dirt and McGurk and press forward medium punch a bunch and then charge an EX headbutt in the middle of it. And then it'll work. Actually, one of my favorite setups is
I'm looking for these
during block strings as Urien, if you charge like a light or a medium headbutt, you can definitely get it. And you can counter hit at people off with
that's
that.
That's Nick, right?
Yes. Can I get a handle, please? Hey boys. Handle?
That's Nick.
Miguel? So we got Miguel on
just
P1.
Just straight up Miguel?
Yeah. And then, what do you want? Do you have a special name? Are you giving yourself a special name?
Oh,
just Raw Dog.
Yeah,
okay.
Just what?
Raw Nick.
Raw Nick.
Just Nick.
Now you got a name. All right, fine, whatever.
No, I made up that one. Don't give him that. It's normal. Oh, it's Nick.
Kill you all one day.
Please, when you do, please make it. Please make it swift. And yes, Debo Magneto definitely. Jumping light kick is one of her best buttons. Also, I like jumping medium kick from distance. It's really sick. You can set up some dumb tick setups. It's really funny. On the other setup, we have the other birdie playing, and if you notice, he does a lot of setups with can and banana, and that's really what was missing from his game plan. And crashing medium punch for anti-airs.
Oh, loud noise.
Yeah, touch him, yeah.
So we got Cammy and Guile. The next Guile likes to put up the wall. Tries to keep people out. But, you know, Cammy, as Chris G said, am I really going to die to Cammy just pressing one button over and over and over again?
Yes.
Yes, the answer is yes, you will. Oh!
Here we go!
All right, whatever. I guess we play on banned CPT stages. We don't care. I will make them change afterwards because this will give me vertigo. and motion sickness. So actually, this match is actually going pretty quick. Cammy's trying to get in. That's really unsafe.
Yep.
Light flash kick.
It's offense gets versus EX defense. It is the Shocker so. Spear versus the thickest wall.
Except this guy will definitely can groin. Don't be surprised if next round you see cross up oh. light kick, light oh. into flash kick. Set up with the Sonic Boom, gets DP'd for free.
She's got to be careful. Oh, no!
Well, that's usually what happens with Guiles. They get you into a range, and then they'll just Sonic Boom.
That Gwheel.
Yeah, the Gwheel.
That Gwheel!
If you notice, that Sonic Boom practically hit cross up.
Yep.
So there you go.
Sonic Boom, the best special. Projectile ever.
Press medium punch, win.
Yeah.
Very good normals. Good understanding of when he's negative. The overhead kick. Overhead kick definitely.
Oh, that can be big. Oh, nope. It didn't connect all the way.
No crush counter. No setup. Gets to go. Nope.
Oh, that could have been.
That definitely could have been huge. He tries to anti-air.
Oh, no.
Crouch
right.
medium light fireball. Game one to Nick. Nick Skyle's been around for a while. Nick's
Did
been
playing. You mean for that to run?
Yeah. Nick has been playing Guile since like Street Fighter 4. So
he's been playing Guile for quite a while. He fights Ryan Vile.
Yeah, actually. Oh, okay, I guess
to get here, he walked a mile.
Ha! We're going too far. Someone called Danny and let him know that I've committed atrocities. There we go. That's the normal set play of Guile.
Yep.
There we go. Looks like Guile from Super Turbo, except for that V-skill.
Oh, yeah.
Got pressure.
Basically back to his annoying Street Fighter 4 person.
Look at that stand jab anti-air. Was that OP? Nah, it was good. It was fine. That was sick.
Just let the tiny blonde girl hit you.
So the stand jab for most characters don't work very well, but they still work for catching people who have dive kick setups because of the delay. And you hit them before their hurtbox actually becomes their hitbox becomes active.
Oh, she didn't believe.
Almost.
She didn't believe that would hit.
Goes all the way through, nose to throw for punish.
He was ready for it.
And no confirm.
Nope.
Unfortunately, it's going to be a rough one. Tough.
Oh.
Dash and throw.
Suplex.
There you go. Ooh. In the corner. Set up. Is he going to go for the EX flash kick or what's he going to do? What do you think?
Oh.
I say EX flash kick.
No. I don't know. I think Kyle's going to wake up hard. Yep,
there it is. You're right. You win.
Great.
I was wrong.
I thought of a name, honestly. The Guile from Ohio.
His new name is the Guile from Ohio.
No.
Nah.
All right. 2-0 in favor of Nick T. Oh, I can't wait to edit out all of that.
Please. Every single bit of it.
Every single PlayStation menu. No one respects the streamer.
Yeah, really, nobody. Stop playing on controllers, play on sticks. Fuck. Up next, more Street Fighter V action. Here at 16-bit Barn Arcade. This stream is brought to you.
Zach and Armando.
Zach and Armando? So coming up, we have Zach and Armando. This should be really interesting. Zach is
War Machine.
Last Huzzah?
Yeah.
Why? That's your name?
Yeah.
Last Huzzah is one of them. So we got you. So this should be an interesting match. It should be Urien versus Dalsum.
Where is he? Yeah, War Machine is right there. All right.
Last Huzzah versus War Machine. So,
right.
is
so
it going
to
be real?
By all accounts, we're going to have a... Oh, shoot, I forgot who Huzzah was playing last time.
Urien.
That's right.
Urien versus Dalsum.
That's right.
Unless he chooses to switch to one of his pockets.
His eight pockets.
He has them. He also has a pocket.
He's basically like the merchant in Resident Evil 4. It just opens up like so many pockets.
What are you
what
selling?
Are you buying?
What are you selling?
I've got a nice Dalsum for you.
Oh, I love that character. He's fucking godlike. They should put him in Marvel vs. Capcom Infinite.
What would he do, die?
Throw items. He just opens his coat and items come out. It'll be like every Melty Blood character.
That's gonna be nuts.
That's gonna be sick.
Oh, we just picked up Debo Magneto as a follower. Thanks,
Woo!
Debo.
Thanks a lot.
No!
After...
Yeah.
Got my,
Oh, we got 8 viewers in there.
Hey, let's go.
Hey, what's up, 8 viewers?
Post this match, I'm going to be, taking a quick smoke break, and, I'm going to have,
Eli, you smoke?
Yeah. The stupendous, the magnificent, the one and only Thu.
I am ashamed.
Someone let Ming know that Thu's going to be on stream.
Who's gonna
Please
be on stream?
Please do not pick a banned CPT stage. How are we ever gonna become a CPT event?
Well, you heard it here first, folks. Taco Supreme, aka Game Over for You Kid, aka
Two
of the Night.
Oreo
versus a Rog.
Funny story. Last Tazana's first character
hit me with
was Balrog.
Ah!
So he's known for his Balrog, and he swapped to Urien.
Well, let's see if he knows how to defend against him as well as he knows how to play.
I'm pretty sure he should be okay, but in this is literally battle of the top tiers right now. The question is close or no close?
Close.
Okay.
Well, I for one will be
see the
rooting
neutral game
for big green Balrog with his little back gloves.
I'm going to go for Urien.
All right.
For third strike. So he's getting already smacked hard. All the good buttons. So it looks like...
I'm using my fight money for Mother Earth.
Yeah, it looks like War Machine actually knows how to play the setup and knows how to win the backdash.
Oh, yeah.
Yep, there we go. Every time.
Zach is a student of the game in the pure sense.
Unfortunately, he missed the free crush counter punish on the EX headbutt.
Rog waiting out that... Oh!
Tries to V-skill. No,
yep,
throw punish? That was a pretty easy throw punish right there.
Oh, if only Rog had his uppercut. Yeah, his DP anymore.
Oh, my God, right? There we go.
Oh, wow.
Yep.
Weird.
That's how that always works that way. It's really dumb.
Send that in a Capcom. I don't know.
Actually, there's only one character who's EX like, oh, here we go.
Oh.
Here we go. Combos. Oh, no. Sorry, but this is not their streak. And they don't work the same.
Oh, wow. Weird catch.
Goes for the tick throw setup.
Stand
heavy kick for the
machine for just a second. Nope, not enough setup time.
Good blocking,
oh,
good understanding.
Wow. Oh!
Good setup.
This could really
crush.
Be over. Oh! Basically, throws on both of them.
Woo. Oh, he sets up for the. Oh,
oh
no.
Deal.
It's.
Oh!
EX low. That is, like, really hard to react to.
That is
to.
Hot shit right there.
Really hard to react to.
9 people in the chat. Welcome, 9th person.
Welcome, everybody. So we got a pretty basic match that you'll see a lot of nowadays.
Yep.
Urien versus Balrog.
Yeah, this happens all the time.
On Street Fighter V, I'm sure. Now that those two are the best, yeah, definitely. So you got good pressure from the Urien.
There's a link to the bracket in case anybody needs it.
There we go. The Balrog's trying to get pressure. Gets a throw set up.
Yeah.
Any late? No meaties.
Nope. The high-low's not working out for him.
Gets a spin.
Needs to switch to Dempsey roll.
Yes, definitely. Someone needs to go make me the Epo skin for Balrog.
Please. Yes!
That would be godlike.
Dude, I would rock that all the time.
I don't
care if I get banned.
I don't give a shit. I'd ban myself.
I'd play on the loser server with all the melee hell play.
Yeah, let's go.
Woo!
Great combo, great setup. That is classic Balrog right there. Especially now.
Ungodly
actually,
power, except for the fact that he just got his ass whooped.
Our local Zangief player just rolls in hella late. We'll see if he's actually able to get into.
All right, so game one for War Machine.
Henry! Are you in or no?
Here we go, round two. Or game two, sorry, game two.
Game two. Balrog up one.
Yep.
So it was just little.
Oh, wow!
Great punish.
Turn punch right into the straight. Oh, off
throw
the
punish. Tries to get for the Oki, but
nope.
It was a bad Oki setup. You shouldn't spin on
that.
Oh,
that should have been good.
EX, that's safe.
Oh.
Good sweep punish.
Empty jump, doesn't throw the straight.
Great combo.
Off.
Oh, no, it doesn't
no.
hit crouching.
Uh-oh.
Stand heavy kick. Actually, he could combo into the heavy headbutt, and that will combo onto crouching.
Oh, baited out the V counter.
But it's one of those things that you gotta, like, practice.
Oh,
the full combo?
Oh, no.
Oh, he misses it. He needed to go kick instead of punch the last one.
I don't think you're too worried about it.
It's okay. I'm just saying.
Yep. Oh!
There you go. Very good, very good.
Look at him.
Good
look
pressure,
look at him look Urien right in the eye.
I believe Urien can go low, like, any combo into heavy headbutt, like, off lights, and actually get the knockdown on crouchers. But it's, or actually, it doesn't work with crouches, but it actually gives you a hard knockdown.
Oh, that was a good setup for Urien off yeah, there it is. He tried it again.
It's actually really good. It's really slow, and you can make your way through it. The only problem is he.
Oh, War Machine's on the warpath now.
Here we go. Nage, what's the breakfast? Buttons on his wake up. He gets hit. No meaty setup.
Very, very short startup frame at target combos.
Woo! He sets up the armor. It's gone.
Yeah, it's gone. And it's gone.
Goes for the reflection. Oh! Mirror, mirror on the wall.
Please don't stop all my balls.
Gets the throws. Very, very weak Urian, to be honest with you. But they're good. They do damage. That's what you need. Great punish with the stand heavy. That's really good.
This is still not unwinnable for Rob, though. Oh!
Oh, crazy winnable. And very good throw.
All right, round two in this match goes to Urian and Lastazov.
So now we got final round.
Final round of the match. Oh!
Hits him with a fireball. Starts going for the anti-air.
Oh, that should have been much bigger. They were both surprised, I think.
I believe so. I don't think either of them thought they would hit. Goes for the low afterwards.
I'm channeling Taco Supreme over here.
That's the theory right there.
That's the theory.
Yeah. Oh, throws him out of the EX startup.
Uh-oh.
Stand heavy going for crush counter baits.
Uh-oh,
fully charged, he can definitely chase it. He doesn't chase it correctly.
Oh, no.
A little bit too far. Stand medium kick. Very good.
Throw range.
I want to see some more abuse of forward medium punch.
Oh, no.
Gets hit with the low. Full combo. No EX. Gets pegged. Now he has to sit there. Can't do Nathan's hot dogs. Gotta cancel it. There you go.
Oh,
backdash out of the throw. Very good read.
Lastazov takes the game.
That was a really good read at the end with the backdash out of the throw. Notice what he was doing on wake up. Notice that he was trying to throw on wake up on those situations. Really good backdash. That's the thing.
All right, last game. This is going to be exciting.
Last game. People need to remember, backdashes in this game,
not invincible.
They're not invincible, but you can't get thrown in the two frames, and then you can't get thrown because you're airborne after that. So
good to know.
So he has to be very careful with doing tackles in this game, because Balrog has been backdashing him.
Oh, yeah.
And if he backdashes him again, he's just going to, it's going to be a real bad time. It's going to be high damage. But good throw setup from the Urian. Good buttons to keep the dashes in check.
Yep. Oh no!
Throws the next dash. Fakes high low. EX goes in.
Balrog's taking it.
Yeah, that's the beauty about long normals. You just kind of poke them out there in this game, and people get tagged. Did that save? Goes for the knee drop setup. Gets hit.
No
combo. Unfortunately.
Oh, what?
There
we
go. Three. A little bit too far. EX.
Oh no.
And he gets hit, yeah. Unfortunate. There's a guy on Twitter that only posts anti-Aegis on wake-up setups.
Nice.
Yeah. So everyone has them, but unfortunately you need health to get through. And he didn't have any.
Oh!
Yeah, there goes the meter. Very bad that he lost that meter.
Yep.
Good anti-air.
Good anti-air.
Hits
solid
him.
Shit.
Standing.
Yeah,
good dash punch. EX dash punch. Into the low. The stun.
Is he going to use it?
One, two.
Need it.
One,
oh,
two.
Oh.
One. That was really good. Good alteration. Good catch from missing the jump in.
Follow up your 1-2 with a straight. That's what Kamigawa says.
Yes. Personally, I like the Dudley style, which is do the Dempsey roll. Yeah. Hit him low and then cancel it into dashes.
Exactly.
Oh. Very safe. That dash is not safe.
Couple light jabs, get him out of the...
Throw setup. Dash in. So, Balrog has setups post-throws, definitely for meaties, and I haven't seen one yet, so maybe this just doesn't know him.
Same thing with Yuri.
Yeah.
Or a new character, who knows?
Maybe.
Who knows what War Machine's cooking up in that lab?
I have no idea. But I got tech for the man.
That's pretty bad. Oh,
good setup. Dash in. Continued pressure, stay heavy.
Crush counter, not quite there, but still good.
There we go. That's what happens. You can't do that.
That is it.
That's a bad meter burn, and he goes.
War Machine taking it 2-1 over Lastazov, knocking Lastazov to losers.
Very, very close match. Very close match.
Good stuff. Good
and
stuff.
And stay tuned, guys, because post tournament there's going to be a 1-to-5 money match.
Oh, with who?
Me and Craig. It's round two, because last time I beat him 5-0, so let's see what happens. And I don't even play the game anymore.
So you take it off for your end?
Yeah, I'm going to take off for 1 second.
Okay, that's fine. I'm going to mute the mic in the meantime, guys. We got more stuff coming up here in just a second. That's right. I said thingy on commentary. You all have to live with that.
Soup? I don't know what he's saying. He's saying something with soup.
Eli's behind the window here, just giving us grief. Meanwhile, Jabber off to a slightly more rocky start this time. Oh, gets interrupted. Oh, but he gets out. Oh, here it comes. Good basic stuff.
Command grab. Nope.
Yep. Oh, tricks him into the command grab.
Another one.
That's that Jabber style. Oh, sneeze. Oh, gets out of it. Wasted meter. Oh, yeah. Using them parries. Using them Dr. Cox's.
No V
triggering,
I would have been
dead. Yep. Birdie taking his time getting that white light back.
Command grab.
There it is! He's got a setup into the command grab. Alright, Jabber taking game one.
Who said that Alex was bad? That was pretty convincing.
Yeah, Alex has won a major at this point, so, I mean, granted, it's not the track record that a lot of others have, but still. People tend to forget the game is still really new. There's still a lot to learn in every direction.
Yeah, for sure.
Not to mention that it's really still not done.
It's far from done.
But I guess when your studio falls on hard times and you throw a Hail Mary to save it, you gotta cut corners somewhere.
At least we don't have to wait for our game while the Japanese get good.
It's true.
You know? Like some people's games over there.
Oh no, did not get out of that one. Alright, Jabber can totally do this. Oh, gets caught. That's the KO. Round one of game two goes to Livewire. Safe enough.
I wonder retaliation if he can find out with command
grab. Yeah, the retaliation was just not quick enough. That was the big problem. Ooh!
Nice answer.
Yep. The only problem in an Alex versus Birdie fight is that while Alex is great at controlling the space in front of him, Birdie probably has a better and easier time of doing it.
Yeah.
Birdie just has so many more options and go directly out in front of him.
He can confirm into headbutt versus Alex.
Alex has a very select move set of actual good moves.
Here we go.
Oh, here comes the big move. Right into the EX powerbomb.
There you go.
Oh, is that going to work? It is. What a combat. That would have stunned if it didn't kill him. Oh, right out of the gate. Didn't catch him into the combo, though. Oh, flying cross chop denied. Jabber losing out of these air-to-airs. Livewire's on the warpath here. Jabber really needs to turn it back around.
Watch the confirm in the V-trigger.
Oh, yeah.
The V-trigger. Oh, that's so
cool. Oh, no, not so enough. Oh, interesting. Oh, no. Oh no, here we go. It's showtime. Standing short kills him. Alright, 1-1 for both players. Jabber and Livewire heading into this final round.
Go John!
Alright. Oh, catches him with a crush counter. Not sure how. Oh, Alex dashing in, getting his shenanigans going. Oh, not safe enough.
Now he knows that's punishing.
Probably not. Of course, there's always muscle memory. Oh, here we go. It begins.
Mix up.
Time to even things up. Oh, one more time into the turnbuckle. Oh, good catch. Oh, makes it safe. No, not enough. Stun lock.
It's not safe.
Oh, here it comes. Gain. No, no, he's still got the magic pixel. Oh. Oh, oh no. Oh, come on. Oh, that's so rough. Jobber's face frozen with concentration. He really needs to focus on this round. Oh, nice. Armoring through. Birdie's spending a lot of meter to keep this thing going. But both players completely drained of super meter right now. Oh, crush counter. No capitalization though. Oh, good hits. Oh, gets out of the throw. Good job, Jobber.
Nice.
Oh, good kick. Nope, too far away. Oh, I think Jobber tried to go for the anti-air there or a dash back. It just wasn't happening. Jobber ready.
I see a lot of jump that Birdie can punish. Oh, yeah. The anti-air is so good.
Jobber ready with full meter. There it goes. Oh, crush counters him out of the clothesline. Oh, no, no, no. Ooh. Oh, 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 no. That should have been so much cooler. Good stuff, gentlemen. That was incredible.
There's no way.
I believe he plays mainly Ryu and a little bit of Rashid. That's what he just told me. Now, Ill Will, I'm not sure what Ill Will plays right now. I'm kind of confused by that. I'm really not sure. And meanwhile, off stream, we have a Ken and Ryu. That Ken from earlier that did the overhead axe kick as an in-ear.
That'll be a good time.
Hopefully
fight.
He'll do it again.
Too bad we want to watch this.
No, I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. So we got a Ryu and a Karen match. It's a pretty classic match right now.
What's that, oh shit. Oh, I'm fucking it up.
You got it. Alright. Are you asking?
I was gonna say, what's Sung Mina say when, it's like, for justice, just kidding, but I just can't remember the Japanese.
Oh my god, I forgot.
Alright, let's see it.
So here we go. Instant jump and sweep, which to be honest is horrible.
Oh yeah, it's
punished,
awful.
But no, on, super when you surprise people with it, it's really good because people won't expect it.
Exactly.
So you got a lot of good pressure from the Karen. Karen's trying to keep her space, going in and then stepping back out. It's really smart. So let's see. Jump in, set up. No full combo.
If only Rob TV were here.
Yeah, if Rob was here, that combo would have been dead. Set up in the throw. So now we know that...
Game one.
Jay Shay will definitely EXDP under pressure, and that's definitely something he should do. It's not something he should not, so. Very slow start. No fireballs from the Ryu, but that's understandable because they are garbage in this game. There you go,
okay,
crush counter sweep. Set up.
Oh,
very good.
We're going
could have gotten a little bit more. Ooh, crouch medium punch into DP. The overhead into the low.
Gotta say.
Crouch medium. Yep. Sweep again. They're trading sweeps.
Ill Will's got some time to make up, but there he is. He's already done it.
Right back into the corner.
Oh, is stun coming? Stun looks like
stun
it's
is starting to go away. Oh, did he catch them again? Right. Nope.
Now he's gonna die before that.
Are we gonna get the oh-ho-ho's?
Oh, good catch. Yeah, he got pressure on. Nope, there he is.
And the overhead over fireball. Very good. Very good.
Shall we all do it together?
By Ill Will. No, once she does it.
Right.
And if not, we'll do a salty ooh-hoo-hoo for not doing it.
All right. Ill Will.
Ill Will, up one. We got the Street Fighter V Classic, the thumbs up.
Illy Willy.
Here we go. Instant dash and throw. Very good. I like that. I like the change.
Shoulder charge.
Good DP on the shoulder charge. Tries to Tatsu, unfortunately crouches underneath it.
This is a marvel. Why are they all getting hit into the air?
Right? Oh, good DP again. Now remember, those aren't invincible anymore.
It's true, you can take the DP out of the character, but you can't take the character
out of the DP. There's the EX side change. For some reason, I would not have done that. I would have kept him in the corner for pressure.
Oh, waiting for the fireball. Waiting for anything. That was super bait.
Activates, oh! And then gets overhead for the fireball. So it seems like if Jay Shay can activate and not throw a fireball, he can definitely get a very strong punish. He just has to do that adaptation. Good Tatsu.
Good touch
medium. No DP for anti-air. Very good touch. Heavy punch stops the overhead right and then DPs mean, accidentally. Machine. I think that was a walk forward fireball which turned into DP. It happens to me all the time.
Happens to the best of us.
Yeah, it's really bad. Oh, gets hit cross up. Full combo.
Oh.
Good pressure. Tries to push him in. Understands it's safe. Good V reversal to keep him in the corner. Offensive V reversal, actually. Set up. One. EX DP.
There it is.
And that's 2-0
for Ill Will.
Everybody on three. Ready? One, two, three.
We didn't preface that.
I'm really sad about not seeing it. I don't preface anything. I throw everything at a surprise.
Maybe later.
I'm telling you, I swear to God, when Karen hits you with the super, she goes, it's time to give you a hoagie. Someone get on the sticks and do a super real
you
quick.
Are killing
I swear
me.
To God it says that.
You're killing
it's time
me.
To give you a hoagie! And then she hits you and she goes, oh, ha, 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 ha. Oh, ha, it was from Subway.
2-0. Are those got, Lego people cups?
Yeah. Nice. Lego people head as cups.
So you Lego people can see head over there. Cups. You see the yellow urns
Jay
in the background?
No.
If Ill Will had popped
off the way. Other side. There you go.
There you go. Those yellow cylinders in the background, full of fear for us. Graciously donated to the cause by the owner of 16-Bit Bar and Arcade here in Columbus, Ohio.
I mean, I don't know if you know, but Chicago Old Style is in Chicago. They have Chicago Old Style.
Everybody, say what's up to the stream.
What you're drinking?
All right, back to the people that matter.
Yeah.
Just you, Eli.
Just me. We got a discount Jeff Goldblum.
Discount, yeah.
I'm sorry.
You're already halfway to being the fly.
Oh, shit. I knew something wasn't right today. So we're waiting on the TO to pick the next tournament. The next match is going to be...
Our mysterious TO.
Well, it's Heather running it right
mystery.
Now. So who do we have going on so far?
Well, let's see. We just had... Well, that was Will Piner. Will was fighting...
Okay, so we can do Seven Men and Pencil Sloth, but we don't know where he is. Let's do Zach and Thu.
Yeah, let's do Zach and Thu. Let's get him out here.
Actually, I'll go grab him.
Never mind.
T.O.'s grabbing him, so that's good. That's good.
Yeah, go ahead. Okay, hey guys, we're back. Sorry about all the trouble there. But we back in this. We're going. We're doing it. Okay, I forget names. Spencer. All right.
This is the first win for player one.
Round one. Fight! Sonic Boom! Sonic Boom!
Yeah.
This is the fourth win for player one.
Lara.
Buddy, and Bite. Final round. Round one, fight! Round two. Fight. Final round. Round one. Fight. Round one. Fight!
I'll save at least.
Round two. Fight. Round one. Fight!
I'll see that you can't.
It was great the other night.
Yeah,
I was trying to get it hooked into my Wi-Fi repeater, and I can't.
Okay, so we got Guile versus Urien. So we got Guile, American-made boy, straight Donald Trump in it, trying to put up the wall. And this heathen Urien is trying to come in with his forward medium punches and Aegis reflectors, trying to break through the wall. So we'll see who gets who. But it looks like Urien's starting to actually get a nice life lead set up. With forward medium punch to throw. Set up again. Again. Throw. Okizeme. Nothing. Never mind. Here we go. Boom loops? No. Never mind. Mid screen anyway, so you can't get the full boom loop. Oh, the Nick T classic. The empty jump low. Wake up. Wake up. Aegis reflector.
Oh.
I shit you not. There is a person on Twitter posting constant tech on how to work around wake up Aegis reflector. With every character. Every character is like maximum damage against wake up Aegis reflector. As a matter of fact, if you ask me, the best one is the Alex one where he does the charge stand heavy kick and he gets like five of them. Because he gets reset by the Aegis. He gets hit by the Aegis, gets reset, presses again, gets hit, and like does it like four times. That shit's so funny.
Nice.
But we got a good match here.
Yeah.
Guile's starting to get in the lead. He's trying to set up his like nice wall. We got Urien with his one-hit armor. There we go. That's exactly what you should be doing. Good crush counter. No continuation of the combo. Good air-to-air. Throw. What's for breakfast? Oh, empty jump low! Empty jump low. That was a godlike setup. What do we got? Ooh, no, he did not!
Wow.
Oh, the dirt! The dirty shit! Oh, and then empty jump low! The crouch heavy, late knee drop into fucking tackle. That combo is disgusting.
I shit you not, I saw that combo on Twitter and I was like, maybe I should reinstall this game. Oh, the side swap, the dirt. You see, this is what I was talking about earlier when about the dirt.
I remember.
Is the dirt that you need to do. Look at this, belt, that's punished, and then that's a throw setup. And there you go, perfect KO. That was beautiful. That's how Urien should be played. The dirty mix-ups, the dirty setups, the insane combos, the super huge damage scaling that hits for 1 point of damage for each hit. That's the shit I'm talking about right there. Last is out, taking it 2-1 over Nick T, making a great comeback, great adjustments on the second round, and then running it all the way back to win the match. Good job to Last Huzzah. Great work. Great work, Ingrid. Now we're waiting on the next matchup. We'll see who's coming up. So, Matt, what's been going on with you in the channel?
Not a whole lot. Every time I record something, something horrible happens.
Oh, no!
As is evidenced by the fact that we've had to restart the stream twice tonight.
Well, A, we're running off a laptop.
It's a good laptop.
It is a good laptop.
Granted, it's not the best laptop.
Also, B, we're working off shitty bar Wi-Fi. So
it's kind of true.
I bet you
can get my repeater working, it's actually got a 5 gigahertz channel.
Oh, then we would be all good. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
So coming up, Zedman and... What's your favorite?
Spencer.
Is it just you? I thought you had like an actual game. If you want to, it's your call.
Too late now.
No, it's okay. I mean, we can make it happen. I just want to make sure. We'll see what happens here. This is one of those where... Well, let's see what the character picks are. Okay, they're what I thought they were going to be. So... If Spencer gets... Oh, matching costumes, matching colors!
Woo!
Ooh, let's go.
I hate it when couples fight.
I know, right? So if Spencer can get the offense going, Birdie does have reversals to get out of stuff. But on the other hand, Spencer's Bison doesn't have any kind of, like, get-off-me tool, except for some sort of, like, an EX Devil's Reverse trying to get out or something. So we'll see how this works. On the Christmas stage... Couples fighting in Christmas. Sounds like real life to me.
Yep. No kidding.
Look at Alex back there. Cold as hell.
Whatever. He loves it. He's got
there you
got
the can.
On.
Can to push him toward... Oh!
Eli in the background.
You can beast... Yeah. God damn it. Apparently you can beast skill the can as Bison. That's amazing. I did not know that. Here we go. I thought Marvel was about to start, but he veered reversal at the perfect time. Real dominant performance here by the Birdie. Now let's see. Setups. Dash through. Gets thrown. Unfortunate. So the meaty timing was off. It's a little early. So unfortunately.
You gotta time that meat better.
Yeah, you gotta make sure that meat is to pure temperature.
Yep, you gotta come out of the oven just
good
right
setup.
Now.
Good damage. A nice 30%. To V reverse. Gets thrown for his trouble.
Oh, don't need
set up directly into
anymore.
The super spends the meter. A good call, I think.
Yep.
About just slightly
down.
In the lead.
Set
good back dash.
You don't care. It's
right into the throw reset. Good air to air. Then gets anti-aired himself. Zedman pressing really good buttons. But Spencer actually doing a lot of work right now, making it back from getting super. If he can win this round, he'll have a real big meter advantage, as long as he doesn't have to blow a ton of meter. And speaking of which, that was a sick combo.
Wow.
Did you see that EX Devil stomp into the fireball?
Oh, don't.
And unfortunate. So far, if you look, the health on the second round was real close. So it looks like the adjustments that Spencer is making is actually starting to pay off. So hopefully on the next round of adjustments will... Sorry, I'm sorry.
You're drunk, go home.
I'm always drunk. I have an alcohol problem.
I'm always going
tearing
home.
My family apart.
Oh shit. East is gonna bring four-player arcade cabs to shuffle.
Oh nice. Can. Gotta respect it.
Respect that can.
On the jumping.
Respect the pouch.
Here we go. Tries
Power Ranger
very good fireball to stop the EX Dolphin dive. Here we go. Continued pressure. Good block on the rear reversal. Understands that it's time. So one of the major things with Bison is understanding when your turn is up and respecting the fact that your turn is up, right? Considering you have no grip, no, very good touch on can. Here we go. Marble time. Good cancel. Side swap. Into the setup. Into EX step. Ooh, the low. Good V reversal.
It's anybody's round.
Yeah, this is a real close match.
I just double reverse all day. I thought it was invincible.
I do like that he's building. He's actually, if you notice, he's just trying to build some meter, trying to stay safe. Good round for Spencer. Very good. As a matter of fact, if you notice, he has a bar right off the rip. So build a lot of meter there is a really good roll. Good play. So now here comes Can. There he goes. The only problem is you can't, like, you can B-skillet. Oh, you actually can get the fireball off of it. Okay.
Oh, good.
So a thing about Bison for season two is if he... You see, that's the same thing as the banana, but except it costs Bison meter.
Gotcha.
So you set it up, and you can, like, counter hit.
Yep.
There's a tick set up.
Very good. Hell yeah.
Overhead. Understanding that he needs some first buttons there, very good.
Crouching jab.
Stand heavy punch. And gets hit the crouching level. So, a change for season two for Bison is he can do B-skill and not hold it, just press it. Like, I think you hold it or something. No, if you hold it, you throw the fireball. If you press it, you store a fireball. And you can use it mid-combo now.
Oh.
There we go, full super. Using the total, using all of the meter, trying to get that strong life lead, trying to use it for pressure. Crouch heavy, very close to stun. There's the stun. And he gets perfect.
Perfect. Well, Sedman takes that one.
Sedman takes that one. That was a real close. It may have been a 2-0, but everything except for that last round was actually really close. So, good job to Spencer. Just a little bit off slightly, and I needed a couple more adjustments to try to make it, but he did a really good job. So. So here we go. Final round. Yeah, this is. I think this is losers finals? Or is this winners finals?
No, Sedman hasn't lost yet, no.
Yeah? So this should be winners finals. I actually didn't know that it was in three.
I didn't either.
Here comes Can. Good anti here. Now get us for breakfast. Two lows. He's trying to find the ABV.
This lager is so classic.
Ooh, there we go. Ooh, the setup. The meaty. Into the stun. Unfortunate. Ooh, the setup. Not sure if that was very swaggy, though. I'm not sure if that was
swagalicious.
I don't think that was. Ooh, good fear reversal on that. And understands that that's positive. That's negative, but not negative enough.
Oh, too far.
And a little bit too close for that kick. Good cross up, stand medium. I'm gonna guess Sedman tried to throw tech there.
Yeah, it could be.
Good pressure. Set up. Devil's reverse. Pressure. Safe. A lot of free life going around. So that's another buff that Bison got just due to system mechanics. Free life takes 9 million years for it to actually regen.
That's true. Oh, there it is. Got him.
There we go. Birdie has him where he wants him, which is right in the corner.
Oh!
Box of V-reversal.
Oh,
on the overhead into the command grab. Overhead again.
Oh, is he going for one more time?
No. Tries to anti-air, stand heavy.
Woo!
Oh, marble time. Good job. Spencer making it up 2-1. It's clutch. Very clutch. Kept his composure. Didn't crack on that.
And Rao has beaten the fat Kenshiro for the win.
This would seriously be Rao if they gave him a fucking knife to stab your foot and do infinite combos on you for it. I miss that game.
I love foot stabs.
I miss that game, man. Ooh, gets the chain.
Are you talking about PlayStation 2?
Yeah.
I never got to play it.
Oh, we used to play it at the at Cat Daddy Arcades. Because we fixed the Atomos Wave.
Okay.
So we played it on like Arcade Perfect.
Oh.
It's really fun. I'll figure it out. I'll get it working someday. So here we go. Making it even. Unfortunately, side swap. Ooh,
oh,
gets me reversal.
Kazuzite.
Again. Understands.
Oh.
That was a hard read on the
card. Wake up.
Yep. Sandman's pressing all the buttons.
Pressing all the good buttons.
And there you go. That's the problem with Birdie. Once he gets a life lead and puts you in that spot, he can literally just press buttons all day.
Oh, yeah.
And you have to respect it. Ooh, tries to go for anti-air chain, misses.
Woo.
Gets anti-aired.
Well, he's
here we go.
The
pressure
set up.
And here we go. See, you notice a lot. There's a lot of trading, a lot of turn taking. Good crush counter into the setup, into the stun. Pushes him into it. Oh, tries to go for the flame pickup, but misses.
Not enough neutral.
I don't think there's enough juggle potential after that. EX Dolphin dive.
One more.
EX Bull into the offer. Beautiful match. Spencer is making the right adjustments and the right reads. It just happened to be that he missed two, and then it happens.
Huh?
M Bison. M Bison. Lara.
Body sapien.
So here we go. Thu versus Ryan. Thu did a good activation. We got a good match. So here we go. Applying pressure. Safe pressure. What's up? Misses the meaty. Good V reversal from the Laura. From Ryan. Tries to jump in, couldn't get it. Fireball. So we got a weird neutral game.
Oh, here we go. The weird setups. A bunch of side changes. Tries to stand jab the V reversal. Ooh, good anti-air elbow. Overhead. Tries to command grab. He through reads it and neutral jumps out. Heavy, heavy scissor kick. Not safe. Brains flub. Neutral jump. Ooh, tries to EX. Good throw tech from Thu in that situation. That's a real heavy pressure situation. Marble time. Cross up setup.
Every time.
Here you go. Ryan in the background is yelling out, every time, man. So he knows what to do. He just has to apply it. Ooh, catches him sleeping. There's the stand medium kick pressure. Good slide. Dash in neutral jump. Dash in throw. There's that armor. I think Thu knew that was coming. Jump. Ooh, the jump back throw option select from Thu. Good anti-air elbow. Going in for the setup. V reversal, V trigger cancel. Dash in, dash in. Thu trying to build some meter. Trying to build some V reversal gauge. So you can go into X Factor mode. So you can switch the game into Marvel. A game that he knows how to play. I'm just kidding. He knows how to play this game too. Fully charged fireballs, the setup. Oh, the devil reverse into the follow-up. And that's it. Ryan with a wonderful performance tonight. Happens to be out.
Happened to not win a round, but.
But very, very strong play, and he's saying next time he's coming for blood. He's gonna kill Thu. He's gonna literally stab him.
Drag him out of the fucking place.
He's gonna drag him by his face out of the place. You ready?
I see.
Hey, listen, as a TO, that serves, that saves you like a minute. That's a minute that you did not have.
Yeah, I know. I'm leaving it open for ventilation.
Gotcha. So we got...
My zipper, I mean.
Definitely. We have Glasses Urian versus...
Urian.
Versus... what is it? Little Mac Balrog?
Yep. Legalize it, Balrog.
Legalize it, Balrog. I call it Little Mac Balrog.
That's pretty good.
Legalize it, Balrog. Let's go!
Yeah.
Naked hype! This is the only way that Urian is Urian is if he has no clothes on. Banana hammock!
Banana hammock!
And there we go. Instantly charged. One hit of armor, it's gone. Try to use it on the Gwayan. Just smart. Go in, tick throw.
Woo.
Spray button to press to stop that. We got fireballs.
I'm the big green buffalo!
I'm a big green buffalo.
I'm like a broccoli workout.
Good button to sit in between for a counter. That's safe. Setups, all safe.
Oh.
Good V reversal to stop the pressure, but.
I like the mythos that Balrog is like a secret weeb and he just like watches a shit ton of Naruto in his room.
He is. He is though. Why else would he hang out with a really, really small white boy?
Human trafficking?
Yeah, that's what I mean. Go set up. Nage. Does goes for the jump out.
Okie zaki.
Gets it out. There we go. Oh, one, two, it. Three, four, five. Jump in. Tries the V reversal, gets thrown. V reversal again. Very smart V reversal this
white
time.
Damage. Oh.
Good throw tech. EX tackle.
That jump was a bad idea.
It does tag a lot. It works really well as a anti-neutral jump. Round two, let's go. Ooh, okay. Stand medium kick, very strong button.
Poke, poke, poke.
Very good poke.
Use those, what was his name? The forgetful guy from Street Fighter 4.
Oh shit, I don't even fucking remember.
That's horrible. Abel.
Abel, oh yeah. Abel would be really good in this game.
Use
with no
Abel
DPs.
Kicks. Oh yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
Rolling command.
So if you notice, they switch stances, they switch sides, and now Urian is starting to push his way through back into the mid stage. They switch sides again. Yes, safe. Understands, good block, doesn't block the low.
Oh, the dashing
see, Urien is doing a from distance back heavy kick because it'll tag almost anything that'll come at him. EX, cancel. Into the overhead. Good blocks. Good throw tech. The trade. 1-2. Oh, sets it real close. He has to respect it. Oh, and pegs the turn. Pegs the spot dodge.
What a JoJo pose for the victory.
Right?
I love JoJo.
And behind us, we got a wonderful raining city. Raining city.
No rain.
Craig! Craig, what is this out of? Out of three? Okay, so
is it?
Semi. It's semis. So winner of this goes to losers final. Right?
No. Alright, this one's out of two then.
I love how I have all the
best of three.
Here we go again. Good buttons for Armando. Good walk back out of the throw range.
Fuck! Eat that shit! Roll down the box!
See, now Balrog is doing a lot more light dash punches and getting him right at the right spots.
Yep.
There you go. Good trade. I believe he's actually plus on the trade. Tries to read something on the EX headbutt. Another trade. Unfortunately, Urien's a little low on health, so his trades are not helping him. Good block. Blocks again, good throw tech. Another block, gets crush counter first trouble. Oh, one. Still alive by a pixel. Good throw tech. Tries to go for an instant overhead, but I don't think it hits. And unfortunately burns the meter and trades. Good try. Backdash at start. Air to air into side swaps. Into pressure, dash up throw. EX headbutt. Goes in. Crosses up the stand medium punch. Ooh. That was a very dangerous shoulder tackle.
Yep.
There you go. Very
shoulder
good.
Tackle.
Puts him in the corner. Dash out that shin throw tech. Continued pressure. Okay. Turns over. Turn reset. Pressure again. Ooh, neutral jump heavy.
Damage. Oh, it could have been something.
No combo. Continues with this extended pressure. Good backdash. V-trigger activate. V-reversal to try to get out.
Two.
No continuation on the combo. Run again. Score is tied up. 1-1. You can tell it's a very heavy momentum-based match. I'm waiting to see some...
I'm eager to see Game 3 of Green Arrow versus Johnny Bravo.
Man, I'm pretty... I missed that show. Yeah, whatever. It's a great show. Here we go. Final round. Thinking over what they're doing. They're good to
That's
go. Here we go. Round one. Final match. Very neutral. Both of them respecting good
the
anti-air.
Pouch.
Good blocks. Good restraint on not pressing buttons in that situation. Understanding that any button would have been a crush counter setup. Gets the V-skill. Unfortunately, that is not safe, but gets a throw because the combo didn't continue. Charge stand heavy punch. Has stand heavy kick.
Oh, good one. Oh.
So he has to be very careful. He's doing a good job. Good anti-air. Ooh, the combo. Unfortunately, misses the meat. He gets thrown. And we're back into this. Ooh, he tries to fireball through it, but he's spun at the last second. V-trigger activate. One. Misses.
No.
Hey!
Oh, he's done, son.
Hey! Unfortunately, that's the power of Balrog right now in this season. He goes V-trigger and you lose. This is kind of how it is.
Oh!
Wow, that was a beautiful air-to-air. Jab, jab.
It's out of the knee dive.
Good EX tackle. Goes for the meteor. Again. Misses, but no strong punish. Good button in the middle.
Every time you say EX tackle, I hear EX
Tatsu.
Taco.
Oh, you hear taco? Sorry.
And then I just think octopus.
Oh, that's fair. EX headbutt.
EX
Dash
octopus.
In. EX octopus. Goes in. Great setup. Gets the meaty timing. Great throw tech from both.
chop.
Here we go. Blocks alone. Veer reversal. DX headbutt. Understands the setup.
Fantastic.
Gets thrown first trouble. Still a lot of V-trigger. Good veer reversal again. And the trade.
Down to the wire on this one.
Muscle power for ya.
And then command grab the guy!
A walk-up command grab too? How do you let him do that on you?
Back to the actual match. Stand heavy kick, very good. EX tackle, really good. Good blocks the V reversal. Getting some good pokes in. Understanding.
He can't get stunned at this point, he really can't.
If he gets stunned, it's over. A lot of white life is building up. Oh, could have been a lot. Stand heavy kick catches whatever he was trying to do.
There's just so much pressure on Uri inside.
Bam. If he had the loops, that would have been over, and that's it. And what's the score?
Last Hurrah goes 2-1 over one.
Last Hurrah wins 2-1. Really funny, because if we're honest about it, they're 1-1 in the tournament sense. Maybe next time. Maybe next time we'll have the tiebreaker for tournament matches, because. Poetic justice? Not really.
You're here. You kneel before me when in my prison.
Okay, last huzzah, up one. Sorry guys, missed a little bit. Okay, going back to character select. Good idea. Get your bearings back, take a nice breather. So this is a pretty even matchup for the most part, excluding the fact that Urien has EX Headbutt to get out of stuff. Other than that, it's pretty even. They both are trying to set up crazy bullshit. They both are waiting for V-Trigger to set up their insane shit. And there's going to be a lot of buttons at neutral, so... Jab, jab, ball. Tries to get a dash in, gets jabbed out. Back to neutral. Gets tackled for his troubles, gets pushed into the corner. Flames out. Crush counter. Tries for it again. Gets stand heavy. Doesn't bite in the stand heavy kick. Gets EX tackle. Throw back into the corner. Nage, nothing. Good V reversal on the EX flame. Stopping the pressure from Crazy Bison. Ooh, stand heavy kick for anti-air and a KO for the throw. Seems like Last Huzzah is really feeling the fire right now. He's on it. Playing real good. Crush counter EX carpet flame. Dash and throw. Dash in again. Gets headbutted for the dash in. Gets thrown, put back into the corner. Gets thrown out of the charge stand heavy kick. Misses the medium. Gets put into the Aegis, only gets hit once. Gets hit again. No continuation of the combo, gets punished. EX stomp. Set up. Invisible. Cross up. Again. Oh shit, good. Two press seem to be pressing the right buttons right now. Gets crush countered. Into combo. Tackle. Oh, into super! Burning it all. Lots of damage. Big health lead. Into pressure. High low. Oh, and there he goes. Gets thrown out of the dash setup. Into the overhead. Jump back. Throw. Good V reversal. No life left. Great. Only gray life. EX fireball. Wow, does not get hit by it. V reversal again to set it up. V reversal one more time. Back to gray life. All it's going to take is one hit. But also, one good hit from Bison will be the end of it. High pressure situation. Gets thrown. Should be still alive. Goes for the meaty. Set up. EX, safe.
Oh!
Beautiful match.
That's it. Good job, Clear. That was good. You got caught in the fireball at the last second. I know. You tried to double reverse over it, didn't you?
No.
No? What are you trying to do? Dash through it? We're trying to dash through it? Okay.
Damn,
Daniel.
All right, go ahead, guys. Thank you.
Real quick, guys, who won the first game?
The first match.
Okay.
Thank you. Round two. Fight.
Round one. Fight!
You can't fight!
Thank you.
Fight! begins. Round one.
Okay, guys, well, there you go. That was Grand Finals. Subman taking it over Spencer, 3-0 in the final game. Match, whatevs. Thanks for anybody who stuck around through all of our technical difficulties tonight. Sorry it was such a weird stream, up and down all the time. I guess the Wi-Fi where we are today, just not that great. As opposed to a couple weeks ago when it was, like, fantastic. So, no idea what's happening there. Hopefully we can get these problems ironed out. But thanks to everybody who stopped by to see our stream today. I have been Matchstick. We've been joined on the mic mostly by Eli tonight, who will be running a Super Turbo tournament at Versus this weekend. Versus featuring K-Brad and various other high-level American players. So from everybody here at 16-Bit Bar and Arcade in Columbus, Ohio, thank you so much for joining us, and we will see you next time. And like we say on Co-opted, hashtag whip it out.